What's going on, guys? It's your boy Bea, and today we're going to be talking about the Nike Vomero 5s. I'll be going over the sizing, the styling, and I'm also going to compare it to one of the biggest competitors, the New Balance 2002R. A lot of people ask the question, is it better than the other? Is it more comfortable than the other? And I'll definitely answer those questions for you, and I'm even going to throw them on feet just in case you want to see how they look on feet. So with that being said and all of that out of the way, let's get right into it. All right, guys, let's get right into it. So as you can see, I have the sneakers right here. I'm not gonna go over the box. The box is whatever. Nobody really cares about it unless it's a beautiful package and it's just a regular Nike box. Quick history lesson on the Nike Vomero 5s. They originally released back in 2011 as a running sneaker. Now, I still recommend that you rock them as a running sneaker because they are very comfortable for that purpose. And I'll get more into the comfort later on. But as far as in 2023, Nike is marketing this sneaker as a casual sneaker. They probably realized, you know what? New Balance is killing this specific space and we want to give them a run for their money. And I feel with this gray right here, it definitely screams New Balance vibes. And a lot of people feel the same way as me. But let's go ahead and take a quick closer look and then I'll tell you more about the sneaker. As you can see right here, we have a beautiful Nike Vomero 5 in the light gray ore, as however you want to say it. Let's go ahead and go over the midsole portion of the sneaker first, which has three technologies, one being the Nike Zoom in this darker gray. In the white area, we have Cushlon technology. And then at the bottom, we have what they call Duralon technology. Some way, somehow, this sneaker feels pretty comfortable, and maybe it's because we have three technologies that Nike is using. Let's take a look at the toe box area, which this is what really screams 2000 from the sneaker. It has a bunch of mesh paneling, along with what it feels like long hair suede panels, which in my opinion feel pretty good, to be honest. Now, in front of the toe box, we have synthetic leather with 3M hints in the outer part and inside part of the sneaker. Now, if we move towards the midsection of the sneaker, we have the 3M Nike swoosh. And this, of course, when direct light hits it, it shines on you. And then towards the back, we have like some type of rubber paneling that, in my opinion, looks pretty cool. And then we have more synthetic leather, more of that nice 2000 mesh, as I call it. More synthetic leather with 3M as well. And then towards the back area of the sneaker in the heel area, we have a hard plastic cage to pretty much give you some support and structure in the back area of your foot in this kind of like geometric type of style. Then we take a look at the back of the sneaker. We have a little Nike swoosh. And then finally, the laces is something to go over because they're just not regular laces. It's kind of a off-white, creamish white, at least that's what it looks on my lighting, with 3M hints. That is a very nice touch. In my opinion, this sneaker looks very, very clean. Honestly, with these gray tones and gray paneling, it could really give New Balance, a run for its money. To be honest with you, if you are a Nike boy at heart and you don't mess with anything else other than Nike, then this is probably the way to go. Now let's go ahead and go over sizing really quick because sizing is really important. I feel that sometimes YouTubers might say, oh, it's true to size, and they just keep it moving. I like to give you some sizing comparisons with other sneakers. That way, just in case you have that, it kind of helps you out. The worst thing is that you buy a sneaker and it's the wrong size and it doesn't fit and it just ruins the whole vibe. Sorry if you hear some type of snoring, but that is my dog. He's like just chilling over there. Matter of fact, give me 1 second.
Yo, I'm trying to record, bro. Yo.
Anywho, in my opinion, these fit true to size. What does true to size mean to me? Well, for example, on Air Max 1s, on Air Max 90s, on New Balance 2002Rs, I wear a size 10.5, and naturally I went with a size 10.5 on these and they fit great. There's only one little thing, and it's that I have a little bit more room in the front area, but it's nothing crazy. But I wouldn't go half a size down because it is definitely form-fitting in the front, not overly exaggerated, not tight. They fit good. They're not, don't worry about if you are a wide footer, still get a true to size and you should be good to go. All right, so some of you might be in this video strictly for this reason right here. You wanna know the comparison. You wanna know whether the New Balance 2002R is better than the Vomero 5s, if it's even worth getting the Vomero 5s when you have a bunch of 2002Rs, if this is actually more comfortable than the 2002Rs, and I'll definitely answer all of those questions, but hear me out. They are both good sneakers. They are both different and similar at the same time. It's like driving a Lexus or driving a BMW. Both good cars, right? The Lexus just seems to be more smooth when you're driving it. If you have a Lexus, you probably know what I'm talking about. If you have a BMW, it normally feels more stiff. There's really nothing wrong with that. It's just your preference. Now, if we compare that same comparison, we're gonna go ahead and say that this is more like the Lexus. It has a more softer ride. I feel that it has the right cushioning in the back, especially in the back area of the sneaker. And then when you go ahead and take a look at the New Balance 2002R, I feel that is a stiffer ride. Overall, the sneaker feels the same. It doesn't feel more stiff in the front or in the back like the Vomero 5s. I'll get into that shortly. But the New Balance 2002R is a great sneaker. Is it more comfortable than this? That is kind of hard to really answer. In my opinion, in my foot, it feels...
I'm not sure I understand.
Bruh. That's crazy. Technology is always freaking listening, and AI is taking over, but that's a different conversation, different topic. Let's get back to these right here. On my foot, they feel comfortable. I feel that they shine the most in the back area. I feel that the back area of the sneaker is softer to the touch, softer when you're walking, and if you're getting over an injury, for example, an ankle injury, heel or back of your foot injury, this is probably going to be better for you. For running, I probably prefer these over something like this. It's softer. I feel that this is going to be better for my joints. I'm not going to feel as tired at the end of the day. If you want a all-around stiff ride but comfortable at the same time, almost like orthopedic type of style, then you're probably going to go with these. If you have a bunch of these, honestly, there's really no point to go and get some of these unless you really feel like these aesthetically look great. Would I get another Vomero 5? Probably. Would I get many? Not really. Would I get more 2002Rs? I probably would do that, because at the end, the New Balance 2002Rs have something over the Vomero 5s and Nike overall, and that is the quality. The quality on New Balance is untouchable. With Nike, we might get some that are good and some that they're not. So at the end, I hope that that answers your question, but they are both comfortable in their own way. That's pretty much it for today's video. I hope it was short, sweet, to the point. I hope it was informative and entertaining. I hope that it answered the majority of your questions. If you made it this far, go ahead and comment underrated. A lot of people say that I'm underrated. I feel that I'm underrated. So go ahead and comment underrated just to really let me know that you watch all the way through and that you really rock with your boy. If you haven't done it by now, go ahead and hit subscribe. Smash the like button. It really does mean a lot. And also hit that bell. That way you get notified every single time I drop a video. Also, if you're not doing so, follow me on Instagram at CarlosVega101. I'm always telling you the date and time of my videos, and it's just a good way to keeping up with me as well. With that out of the way, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace. Thank you.